The moment has come for me and Alex's last Magic Kingdom style Disney park. Here we are at Tokyo Disneyland. Hey. Oh my God, this is it. Disney park, Magic Kingdom style park number 6. And here we are, opened in 1983. And this was actually the first Disney park to be built outside of the United States of America. And look at it, it's probably going to be the busiest we've ever seen a theme park today. Look at this place. We've heard about the crowds and it looks absolutely stunning. There we've got the Tokyo Disneyland Hotel. And here we are entering in to this park's version of Main Street USA, which looks very, very similar to what you'd expect from the usual Main Street USAs. However, it's actually called World Bazaar. And it's also got a conservatory over it. It feels very, very different actually already. Of course, join us throughout the day as we share lots of footage, on-ride footage, off-ride footage from this park. And this is very, very different, isn't it? Where's Town Square? That's the answer. Oh my God. How different is this? It is very different. So the park has literally just opened. Some of the best opening hours ever for a theme park, 8 a.m. until 10 p.m. So I can't wait to see it all, and hopefully we're going to get everything done. So we've got 4 days to spend here and at Tokyo Disney Sea, which will be Disney park number 12 for us, and that means we've completed all 12 Disney theme parks. Oh my God.
There's no commitment to what ride we're going to go to first. We're just going to go to one that hasn't got a big queue. Yeah. This park is incredibly busy today.
It is busy. I'm really liking this though. It's very, very different, but I am liking it. How strange having the roof on. So there we go. This leads out into different areas of the park. Very, very different, isn't it?
I like it.
I like it. Yeah, I think all these Disney parks have got their own sort of feel, and this certainly has. Right, let's proceed and let's have a little look around. Wow, I just can't believe we're here. Different to what I was expecting, but this central plaza area is so open. There's so much sort of viewing area and space to walk about between the areas, which is really nice. I'm enjoying this so far. It's very, very different. That's what I've enjoyed about the 3 Asia Disney parks that we've done so far. They've all been so different to each other and very different to the parks that you get both in Paris and over in the US. They've got so much charm, and every Disney park's got charm, but these ones I've really, really enjoyed seeing and exploring. And of course, you probably already recognise it anyway, but you've got Cinderella's Castle just there. Pretty much identical to what can be seen over at the Magic Kingdom at Walt Disney World in Florida. However, here it kind of fits in a little bit better, I think, and it's a slightly different shade of colour scheme on there. I really like these turrets they've got out the front here as well. They're really nice. I assume that hides all the technology for all the shows.
Slightly different shade of castle as well.
It is, yeah. It's got a bit more colour to it, hasn't it?
It's a bit more like storybook from the colour scheme, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does, definitely.
It's very cream. Colouring. It's nice, it's beautiful.
Yeah, big open central plaza, lots of open space. But it's still got a lot of trees and things. Bear in mind, this park did open in 1983, so it is quite an old Disney park. I just can't believe that we're here, to be honest. And obviously tomorrow we'll be visiting Tokyo Disney Sea, my most anticipated theme park ever in the world. I can't wait. Look at that, really nice. Castle fits in beautifully, yeah. Oh, it's so nice to actually have a Frontierland. I say a Frontierland, much like the World Bazaar area. This is actually called something different as well. This is actually called Westernland, which is quite interesting. However, it'll always be known as Frontierland in my heart because all the buildings are very, very similar to what can be found in the other Frontierlands across the world. It's so nice to actually have
little things details, like the Alliance Hotel.
Little details like that really make it. Name. Country Bear Jamboree, Vacation Jamboree. It's nice to actually have a proper Frontierland here, so to speak. The past two Disney parks that we've done on this trip, we haven't had a Frontierland. Obviously, when we were at Hong Kong, we did get Grizzly Gulch, and that was really nice. I enjoyed it in that area. We've seen so much stuff, it's crazy. Oh, wow, look at this.
I think you'll find this is the queue for a Big Thunder Mountain.
Oh, wow. It is busy. And there's Splash Mountain just over there as well. It's a very, very big Western Land. God, it's strange calling it that, Western Land. It doesn't sound right. Frontierland. I still can't get over how big the open spaces are. A little insight for you, I'm not a big fan of theme parks that have got massive open footpaths like this, I will be honest. I do like the more quaint little paths and everything like that. However, this is very, very different. I'm glad we're here to see it.
Nods to the original park though, with things like the Rivers of America with the Mark Twain riverboat on there.
Yeah, I can't wait to get on the Mark Twain later on. Mark Twain!
Thank you.
This is really nice down here in Western Land. Just come off the main path to a bit more of a quaint little path. And these are the little paths what I really like, and that's what makes Disneyland for me. Tom Sawyer Island over there, of course the Mark Twain. This is a really nice version of Big Thunder Mountain. Looks like all the station and queue lines all up here. Obviously some of the ride coming out. This is obviously the exit. This is really nice down here, very immersive. All the big cactus.
Mental here today, though, isn't it?
It is a busy day today. Bear in mind, it is a weekend day. However, I have been told that it's not much different in the week at this park, with it being the same opening hours all the way through. Or long opening hours, should that be. 100 minutes for Big Thunder Mountain.
Gosh.
It's crazy, isn't it?
Because of the park's open as late as it is.
It is. So many little details in this queue line for Jungle Cruise. Got the radio room over there. Look at all those trophies on the top. It's all the little things like that that I like looking at. All the little details. I must say that operation so far, amazing. Like, we've only been in this queue 10 minutes and we've only literally got there and we're on. The queue's been constant moving like this. We've hardly stood still. So quick at throughput. This park has been designed to handle crowds very, very well. Hello.
あっという間に1週間が経ちました。ここは雨の森です。この海には美肌効果があるので、こうやってお肌にパサパサしたりしてください。ジャングルの栄養分が豊富に含まれています。多分シャミ、ゴリラの汗、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻水、ゾウの鼻
Thank you. absolutely crazy. So literally about 3 minutes ago, a train came out. This one's now going out, and there's another train about to come in.
They've really thought about this park. They really have, in terms of Rupert's and the cast members. Brilliant. I'm really enjoying it so far. I'm not too sure on the layout that we've seen, but in terms of attractions, it's really, really good and very different. So we came off the Jungle Cruise just, and that was, as I just said, very different. In terms of that ride, it was a lot more advanced, so to speak, than the other ones. It started off very different as well, in like a canopy with all that magical music, and I thought, oh, it's just a bit of a different opening. As we went into the attraction and followed it round, of course you got all your classic elephants and all that kind of stuff at the sides, but it had like a soundtrack in each scene in the background, and I really enjoyed that. There was one though, there was the Lion King soundtrack on like the Savannah Plains sort of area. I don't really think that fit in very well. I do kind of like the classic sort of Jungle Cruise as it was, but I do like the fact that it had scores in the background. It made it very, very different, and it was more of an experience, so to speak. Would I like all of them to be like that? I'm not too sure, but I do like having these different versions of the attractions. I think it felt very advanced for a Jungle Cruise and a little bit too modern maybe, but I really enjoyed it. As you saw by the cast member at the front, she was like really getting into it, getting everybody clapping along, and yeah, really good. I did enjoy it. There was also the room at the end there, much like the version of Magic Kingdom at Walt Disney World, where it actually had a dark ride section, like a temple. I really liked that, and there was all projection mapping in there. Again, very different. It didn't feel sort of like traditional Jungle Cruise, but I really enjoyed it. And again, yeah, something different. You got anything to add on that?
I love it. I love this little park. Well, a little park. Big park, really. Operations, fantastic. Throughput's incredible. I mean, If things are on a 110-minute wait, imagine how much it would be with that operation. It would be 220-minute wait.
Yeah.
And I also have to point out as well, I found this quite funny. We've found three cast members so far that have the names of car manufacturers for their names. We've got Toyota just over there. We've got Suzuki down there. There's someone called Corsa in the queue line.
Corsa.
What's going on?
Oh my God.
Is this intentional or is it? I'm not quite sure.
Let's get on the Western River Railroad and go and see what this is all about. So friendly. The hospitality here in Japan is
so
top
good.
Class. It really is. I'm loving this country so far. I really am. I really like this. Western River Railroad, 2015. Very nice. Stillwater Junction. Little ticket booth and everything. A little look out there to the rivers of America. Canoes down there. Oh, this is lovely. Really, really out in the wilderness. But it makes you feel like you're out in the wilderness anyway. Also takes us through into Critter Country, home to Splash Mountain, just off there to the left.
Wow.
Oh, this is brilliant. Look at this. Mark Twain Riverboat, all the rivers of America. Really nice train. I was saying to Alex actually whilst we're in the queue, it's nice to actually come on a Disney railroad where you're not just seeing trees all the way round and the backs of attractions like warehouses and all that kind of stuff. This, you get some really, really nice views. I mean, look at that. Stunning. Can't wait to have around the March Lane later.
あ、美味しいね。これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しいね。あ、これも美味しい
Just come off the Western River Railroad, really absolutely love that. It's my favourite of the Disney railroads. I thought that was really gorgeous way of just showcasing all this area of the park, all the Western Land and Adventureland. It was lovely, all going around the back of the Rivers of America. Really immersive. And very clever of Disney how they got around that by only having the one station. It not being a big continuous sort of loop with loads of stations. Just that one station, there's a fake station around the back. It was very, very clever, and I really enjoyed it. Beautiful views. A little bit about the Fastpass system. Pretty similar to what you get at most of the Disney parks here. Your standard Fastpass ticket machines. You literally scan your ticket. You go up to your Fastpass booth like this. So it says return time between 12:50 and 1:50. The queue time at the moment, which is 120 minutes. Then you'll scan your park admission ticket and get one of these little bad boys. I still really like this system. As much as I enjoy the Magic Band system, it's all a little bit too pre-planned for my liking. I do like how you can still come and get the traditional tickets, much like you can do at the majority of the Disney parks. So we'll be back for Big Thunder Mountain at 12:50.
Welcome to Critter Country. Oh, wow, look at this. Now, of course, Disneyland over in California has got a Critter Country. But this one's massive, it's huge. It goes all the way down there, all the way around here, lots of little pathways and everything. But it's got something very special for any big fans off Splash Mountain. That is gonna be our next ride, we're gonna head on Splash. Here we are. Got Grandma Sara's Kitchen, which is effectively a Splash Mountain restaurant. And look at this, very, very nice. Let's go and have a look inside. I've been trying to show you inside quite a few of the different restaurants on this trip. A look at your menu just there. Alex is in the queue getting some milk. Look at this. For any big fans of Splash Mountain, get yourself out here to Tokyo Disneyland and come and see this. Also, you walk in, that's obviously on ground level, and then you go down the steps just there to make it down to where you pay. Look at this, so many details. There's pictures up everywhere. Splash Mountain restaurant of all things. Lovely, isn't it?
I'm really enjoying seeing all these Disney parks, just exploring them. It's just amazing to finally see them all, but it is also quite sad the fact this is our last Disney Magic Kingdom style park to see, number 6, and of course tomorrow we'll be in Tokyo Disney Sea for the first time, and that will be actually our official last Disney park. All 12 will be completed tomorrow. It is crazy to think we've done them all, but I've loved this trip so much, and just seeing it all, like little things like this and
all the different versions. It means we've done every version of Splash Mountain in the world too, all three versions: California, Magic Kingdom in Florida, and Tokyo Disneyland. But yeah, I thought I'm just gonna have to show you this because I know there's a lot of fans out there of Splash Mountain. Just look at it, all the details like this, look, so nice.
Yeah, hidden Mickey, yeah,
there
is.
What's that?
There's a hidden Mickey as well.
Hidden Mickey up there in the rock work. Look at this, indoor station for Splash Mountain. Wow. Here we are then on the front row of Splash Mountain. Very different. Hey. Hello. The detail and scenery all around Critter Country is fantastic around here, really nice. Do you like this on the front of the boat as well? All the little Disney details. Park train. That's gorgeous, that is, looking all the way across. Here we go, drop number one. Are you ready? It is a very different layout, yeah? The other two are quite similar, really. Dropping straight into the indoor section, it seems. Off we go.
Oh, no. coming to pack my sack. I'm heading for a little more adventure.
With this being the only like international outside of the United States Splash Mountain, it's very, very different, isn't it, to hear it in another language?
Seems all in on the border. Animatronic's very good though.
Yeah, brilliant.
Yours, you got
like all the roof in here, very nice.
Oh,
it's a really big indoor section.
Are we in luck? Oh, this isn't it the laughing place? Yep.
Everybody's got a laughing place. A laughing place. Here. Oh,
a waterfall.
Here we go. Get ready for a nice view.
Wow.
Oh, look at that. Mark Twain. Here we go. Splash Mountain. Wow.
Oh my god, it's a water splash.
That's a soaker, that one.
Whoa.
Wow, I think you get wetter on that than the other versions.
Oh, definitely.
Oh my god.
Well, we appreciate it, boy.
That was really good, that one, especially on a really hot day, about 30 degrees again today. Wow. Good old splash. Zippity lady. Really like the lanterns in here, they're nice. Everything is satisfactory.
Wow, I am loving the onload and offload stations here on Splash Mountain. I didn't actually expect quite as many differences as Alex pointed out on the ride. The scenes were in a very different order to what you'd be used to on the other two versions of the ride. Let's talk about it in general. Of course, you've got the indoor sort of station area, quite a bit of indoor queue line there as well, and it's just really, really nice. I do like how it's all enclosed. Kind of a lot more dark ride element to that than there is a flume ride, so to speak. Very, very nice. Of course, you've got your typical scenes in there, but they are in a very different order to what you're used to. There's a lot of little details everywhere in there that are quite different to the other ones. I do prefer it themed to Critter Country, like this one and the version at Disneyland there in California. Obviously, Magic Kingdom's version is themed into Frontierland. Obviously, all these same sort of characters and things, but it is sort of, the soundtrack's a little bit different and that sort of thing to fit in with Frontierland. So yeah, I did really, really enjoy that. It was great, wasn't it?
Just get on it. Big things coming from me already. Always big things from a big guy. Operations at this park, probably the best I've seen at a Disney park.
Yeah, the best I've seen in the world, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, that ride, yes, it was stacking as we were going round, but that's due to the amount of boats there is on the system. I've never seen operations quite like it in a theme park. And the amount of cast members there is readily available to speak to for questions, just meeting and greeting is very, very good. The hospitality, I know I've mentioned it quite a lot while I've been in Asia, but definitely in Japan, it's taken it to that next level, and there's even just cast members standing on the exit just waving goodbye.
I didn't think you could get better than China, and Japan's just topped it again. Everything seems to keep topping itself. And to be honest, I've got to say this, currently at this time, we haven't even done the part we're most anticipating, so I look forward to seeing how our opinion goes from incredible to spectacular.
Yeah, I mean, I was sort of came into this park expecting not massive things, really. When people talk about Tokyo Disney Resort, I always think about Disney Sea and everything in there. I didn't really think much about this, but now we're actually here and seeing it. Yes, it's a different layout and there's quite a few big open areas, but there's also some gorgeous areas as well. Like, look at this, having the train running round, the water wheel. It is beautiful, it really is. But yeah, that was a very, very nice version of the ride. I love all these different versions of Splash Mountain. I think they're all absolutely fantastic, and you've even got a meet and greet here as well. That's quite cool, isn't it?
Love it.
Yeah, that's really cool. Meet and greet right at the exit. Yeah, so many little details everywhere, and there's quite a lot of seating areas all the way around this area as well. It's nice to see Critter Country with a bit more sort of than just Splash Mountain, if you know what I mean. It's got so much more to it, having the restaurants, all these seating areas. Yeah, and meet and greets as well. Very, very nice. I love it.
Welcome to the Hollow Hideout, y'all. Nearly got the name wrong there. What do you think of my little poncho neck towel thing? It's so cool, isn't it? Don't you like it?
Hey, look at that.
Awesome, dude. Like, oh my
Tokyo
God.
Tokyo Disney Resort, the merch here looks incredible. But look at this. So what is it? Like a... You wrap it around your head.
You put it over your head and you wrap it over your shoulders to keep you dry and warm.
But I'm dry and warm anyway. It's 30 degrees.
That's really dry and warm as well. Other ones are available as well. Very nice. And probably my favourite t-shirt ever.
I love that. That is quite nice. Merch will be spent. Lots and lots of
merch. Won't be spent. Money will be spent.
Yeah, it's going to be crazy, isn't it?
That concerns me.
I can't wait. There's going to be a lot of merch being purchased.
Just little details of this place. It's crazy.
What do you think of this Critter Country? I mean,
probably,
I love it.
Probably the best.
Yeah, definitely the best Critter Country. I think it fit in so well with Western Land. I keep wanting to call it Frontierland. Western Land. Oh, little squirt from the mountain. Yeah, look at that. Still one of the most impressive rides out there in the world. All versions of Splash Mountain are absolutely incredible. They really are.
And this one might look smaller, but don't worry, it isn't. It's
definitely not. It's got
landscaping.
Yeah, a lot more sort of inside as well. A lot more interior sections.
So they actually do something very different here that we did know about before coming from watching other people's vlogs actually, but now we're actually seeing it into practice and seeing how it actually works. Basically, for some of the main shows in the parks and that sort of thing, you actually need to go into a lottery. With it being that busy here at Tokyo Disneyland and Tokyo Disney Sea's the same, you have to go into like a lottery system where you get an instant sort of reply to whether you can go and watch the shows. So what you do, you come into here in this park, it's Tomorrowland, you come into this building just here, and you see all these machines all the way around the side. And what you actually need to do is scan your park tickets. So you go to a machine, all of you and your party together, scan your park tickets, so with there being two of us, we scan them, and then you select what show you want to see,
and then you get told instantly if you get a seat in that show venue or not. Unfortunately, we didn't actually get a seat that time. It's a very interesting system, I'm not sure on it.
We were not successful, go and queue up, basically.
So. Yeah, so I'm not too sure on it at the moment. I think it's one of those things where you might need to get here early, but even if you do, surely then it's unfair for people that come later on. So I'm not too sure, it must be just literally a random, it selects yes or no to that person. Very interesting, I can see the logic behind it, because if they did it on a first come first serve basis, the queues would get manic and people would also be running to it on a morning. So I can kind of get that, but on another hand, I'm not too sure on it at all. Yeah, it's one of those, it's a bit different, but I can see they've had to do something with it being a busy park. I mean, I've never seen a theme park this busy before in all my life.
So we failed.
We failed that time, but oh well. That was just for the one of the big stage shows just around here. For the fireworks, it doesn't seem that we need it tonight. Whether it's the same all the time or not, I'm not too sure. But yeah, it's Tomorrowland Hall in Tokyo Disneyland for that one. And make sure you have your park tickets because you'll need to scan them for that. And girls, we're now back down at the World Bazaar, aka Main Street USA, at Refreshment Corner for Sean's food review, part one.
Tokyo Disneyland. Dun, dun, dun. There we are. So this is basically like the Casey's Corner of this park. I must say, Alex, I'm loving your t-shirt today.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, very, very nice.
I have to show you something very cool with this milk. Go on. Milk bottle. Let me.
That straw looks a bit small.
It does look a bit small, Sean. I'm going to show you a cool little secret with this straw. How does that sound? So, normal straw, you ready?
I'm ready.
So good, isn't it?
Yeah, I love it. And Alex has actually got a cheese dog, fries, and some milk.
Of course.
You enjoying that? And I've got an all-American hot dog, fries, and some Coke.
Food-wise, we're coping well. We found somewhere that we like. You can't go wrong with Casey's, wherever it is across the world.
Here it's called Refreshment Corner. And we're back on Coca-Cola here as well, after the Pepsi.
Pepsi.
Yeah, no more Pepsi, please. Really, really nice World Bazaar. And fantastic views of Cinderella Castle. Yeah, really good food. So let's have a little look at this hot dog. Let's have a little taste of this.
It's good.
On a fry.
You know what? Probably the best meal I've had on the trip. 9.5 out of 10.
Hey, drum roll.
I agree.
Yeah, really, really nice that. Lovely. After having a really nice lunch there down at the World Bazaar, we're now going to make our way through Cinderella's Castle to Fantasyland and the Haunted Mansion. A lot of you probably sat there thinking, hang on a minute, did Sean just say the Haunted Mansion in Fantasyland? Well, yes, I did, because it's very strange how the Haunted Mansion is located in Fantasyland. I mean, what the hell? It's so different.
It's really interesting to see how the culture is so different.
I love the culture over here. I really like it. I mean, the people are so friendly and everyone we've interacted with.
I mean, people taking pictures and selfies. And
everyone's just so friendly and got so much time for us. It's lovely, it really is. And that's a really impressive view looking back down that way to World Bazaar. And then, of course, in the background with a blue roof at the back there, the Tokyo Disneyland Hotel. I was saying this morning, actually, before we started the vlog. It's amazing, really, to think that, obviously, after this park in 1992, Disneyland Paris was built. And I think this kind of inspired Disneyland Paris in a way, how you've got Main Street and, obviously, the hotel, which is just behind it. Obviously, here, the hotel is set quite far back. And at Disneyland Paris, the hotel is built right above the entrance. But I definitely think this is sort of an early inspiration to what we got at Disneyland Paris, really. Yeah, this is really nice. Very nice castle. Like I say, the colour scheme, very different, actually, to that of Cinderella's Castle in the Magic Kingdom in Florida. I mean, let's be honest now, guys. After going into Shanghai Disney, in the castle at Shanghai Disney, this is just not quite the same, is it?
All I'm saying I have to mention this, that I might not be coming back to England this time right now. I am loving this place.
We're absolutely loving it. Yeah, this isn't quite as impressive as what you get in Shanghai, but don't get me wrong, it's got some really nice mosaics on the wall and everything. But yeah, if you want the ultimate Disney castle, get yourself out to Shanghai. Cinderella's Fairy Tale Hall. So yes, Haunted Mansion is located just to the left. Carousel's out of action at the moment. Also today there is a couple of bigger e-ticket rides that are closed. We did know about It's a Small World. That's closed because of a massive overhaul. It says a new version coming spring 2018. You can see the facade to It's a Small World just at the back, just over there. Obviously the carousel, which will be located here. And then round the corner over in Tomorrowland, Space Mountain's actually closed. Now, I'm not too sure if it's shut for the whole of our trip. It's one of those that we wasn't sure about until we walked around there earlier on. But maybe it's just shut for today and unexpectedly, really, so hopefully we might be able to get on it. If not, it'll be a shame to not do Space Mountain here, but I'll definitely be coming back. I love the parks, but I also, more importantly, love the culture, and I've really enjoyed seeing it all over here. So many amazing sights to see. And it's just brilliant.
People might be too bad either.
It's so strange seeing the Haunted Mansion in Fantasyland just up there. Right behind Dumbo's. Talking to Dumbo's, actually. It's a really like old school version of Dumbo's. It looks like the original one that opened at Disneyland. Obviously, all the other ones have got the up-to-date sort of version. This one looks like it's still a classic, which is quite nice to have those heritage rides.
And the Haunted Mansion looks a little bit more abandoned here than it does.
Yeah, it does actually, doesn't it? Yeah, like the windows at the top, yeah. Let's gonna have a closer look at that.
The theme is great.
Yeah, it is, yeah, especially that top window just there. Let's have a little zoom in. There we are. Oh, hello, Theme Park Worldwide on YouTube. Get yourself on. But yeah, all abandoned windows. Let's go and have a closer look at the Haunted Mansion.
Do you ever want to see fake fences at Disney? Come this way, look at this. That looks very metallic, and to be fair, most of it is, but this little spike on top looks a little bit too dangerous for my liking, but no, don't worry about the Disney part, because look, it's rubber.
Wow, the little details.
Very, very cool. Look at that.
Even
the castle.
I love it.
Very nice.
Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host.
So here we are, about to board our Doom Buggy. On the Haunted Mansion, our last Haunted Mansion to do. Oh, it's so sad saying all this. Good good high throughput rides, these. Mansion then.
And in my opinion, I thought it was very similar to that with the Magic Kingdom over in Florida. Obviously it's the same sort of exterior, the interior as well, the layout was very similar, the scenes were very similar, and to be honest, every single version of the Haunted Mansion that I've ever done, I love it. It's the soundtrack, it's the 999 Happy Haunts, the Hitchhiking Ghost, everything all coming together, which really makes a fantastic ride. The one thing that was different in there was like some spider webs scene in there, which was interesting. Instead of having the staircase scene, there was like spider webs. I thought that was a bit of a lazy way out, so to speak. It was just a very dark room. I couldn't even film it. It was that dark. And literally just some cobwebs from the spiders, and I wasn't too keen on that instead of having the big staircase scene. And also, which was quite interesting, there was a few little jump scares in where the attic scene is in a few of the different versions. And from that many now, they're all starting to blend into one. But where's the attic scene? This one had a few more jump scares in there where the bride is, which was quite cool, which I quite liked. But yeah, overall, brilliant. I mean, my favourite scene in there has still got to be all the sort of the banqueting hall and everything going on in there. It's amazing, it really is. The animatronics in there seems really up to date and really seems to look, especially in the finale scene, look fantastic. And of course you had the singing bus there as well. Yeah, really, really nice, I enjoyed it.
You like it?
I like it. I think it's a lot more modern than the Magic Kingdom version. I don't know whether it is a lot, but it just felt a lot more.
Yeah, I agree. More presented. Fresher, yeah, definitely.
Feel free to disagree.
Maybe it's just come out of maintenance for something, for all we know as well.
Possibly so, but it did look very nice. I see what you mean with the resemblance of the Magic Kingdom, and it kind of had elements of all three main ones, the Phantom Manor and the two Haunted Mansions in the US, so nice that it's sort of little bits have been picked out of each and shared about, which is really, really cool.
It is, yeah. It's nice to get back on Haunted Mansion. I do really, really love Mystic Manor to bits, but it's still good to get on a Haunted Mansion and try that. Yeah, we're having a really good day so far. I'm really enjoying the park. At first, I was a bit unsure on the layout, and so I'm a little bit unsure, but I like it. It's different, and there's some really, really nice little quaint areas mixed in with your big open footpaths. I think the reason I think the paths are so big is because of the parade route. Normally, your main parade viewing area will be Main Street. Here, with it all being covered up and with it not being that, I think that's why the paths are a lot bigger around the rest of the park. So the parade has to come around the different routes instead of being on one long street. So, yeah, very good.
Welcome to the magical Snow White Wishing Well.
This is nice.
It's got a grotto.
Santa's grotto?
Oh, wait.
You might notice there's still quite a few like Easter-related things around the park. The Easter celebration's still ongoing here at the moment, even though it's, what, the middle of June now. Seems like it goes on for a long time.
They're like
Cadbury eggs, don't they? Yeah, I like their Easter eggs. Little things like that, though, and of course a little bit of street theatre that we saw just the jazz band.
You can't have a Disney park without a live band, can you? Really, really good. It's all the little things like that what really make it.
And as Alex is now demonstrating, water is available, drinking fountains around the park. Really good, so it doesn't mean, oh, look at him having a good drink there. His dad's always spending the money on drinks. In terms of temperature, it is hot today, but humidity is quite low, so it's quite nice, actually.
I thought you were seeing the weather girls, the training men, then.
It's raining, man.
I thought you were.
I'm not. We're making our way down to Big Thunder Mountain to go and use a fast pass. Really making the most of the fast pass system today.
Fast Mountain. I'm going to let myself get absolutely soaking wet.
And cut. That's it. BTM. So first impressions of Big Thunder Mountain are, wow, very, very impressive. Looks really, really good. You can just see the mountain just there behind the station. Got the Western Land Town Hall just here as well. Established 1872. Western Land Shooting Gallery. This is lovely around here, really nice. I like how the queue line goes up through the hashtag rockwork. Look at that, lovely. I always love Big Thunder Mountain. Let's face it, Grizzly wasn't a patch on this. Can't wait. Glad we got a fast pass though. That's a nice big tanker there, look at that. Loving this queue line. Really nice.
Coming out, the fast pass is going
on. I know, yeah.
What the hell?
Oh, I do really like this. Very different to the others. I say that, every day is a Big Thunder Mountain at all the parks.
It's got its own touches and very different.
It's lovely round here though, with the rivers of America. Great view of the coast as well.
Yeah.
I'm
not going to be blind legs and knees. Yeah. I'm trying to climb into this.
Things are not designed when you're Alex's height. Yeah. Oh, this is really nice. Really impressive, this. Very nice views everywhere.
See how busy the park really is from here.
Yeah, look at that. Looking back over there. Oh my god. All the long time, folks. Because this here is the wildest ride in the world.
Well, at least in Tokyo.
Let's go. Quite a nice indoor section there. Missed you, Big Thunder. You can't go wrong with Big Thunder Mountain. Beautiful ride, amazing theming. Each and every version of this ride across the world, it's just beautiful. They've all got their own little special touches. Off we go. With us being at the front of the train, you start off quite slow, and when you get down, that's it, you're off. Whoa. Interaction. Head chopper coming up. Yeah. We love a good head chopper.
One more time.
Oh.
every single version of this ride in around the world has got different little tweaks to it. They all follow the same sort of theme. They're all exactly the same thing in terms of Big Thunder Mountain, but they've all got their own little touches.
And that was really good. I enjoyed that.
We're still here in Western Land and we're going for a ride on the Mark Twain Riverboat.
Mark Twain!
There it is. Really like this model, all the flags all around the top. Do you love the riverboats? And there it is. Boats depart around every 20 minutes. Look at that. Beautiful. Goodbye, everyone.
Mark Twain!
Absolutely love the riverboats. I've missed these at the past couple of Disney parks that we've done. So nice to be seeing one again. Bye. It's a bit windy up here on the top deck of the train. You already waved down there on the Becky Thatcher. Hello. Beautiful. Tom Sawyer Island looks massive here, look at this. In the raft drop you off just around there, got all this to explore. We're definitely gonna have to go on there and have a look. Yeah, look at that. Really nice. This Rivers of America looks absolutely huge, and I was just saying to Alex, I really hope that Disneyland in California, when the rivers reopen this summer, they feel just as good. I know they're gonna be smaller and not as long, but I just hope it's got the same feel. If I can see or hear anything Star Wars related from the rivers, it will really take away from the experience for me. I love how the Western River Railroad goes right around Big Thunder Mountain. Look at that. Really, really nice interaction between the two rides. This rivers is gorgeous, and I just think it's a really important part of the Disney parks to have somewhere like this, a really relaxing place away from the crowds, apart from you and 400 other people on the boat line.
40,000.
Yeah, it is. It's very, very nice up here. Standing on the top deck, looking out. So much to see. It is lovely. Really, really nice. Bit of a fire going down there. Go on, Alex, go and jump in and go and save him. I wouldn't. It's about 6 foot deep, if that. Some of the famous scenes all the way around the side. Famous. It's a new word for me, isn't it? Famous scenes. So much little things to see though, like in every little corner. Lots of rock work. With all the Indians all around the side.
I like how the scenes back onto one another as well.
Yeah, it's really nice. It's like that's multi-purpose. You can see it here from the rivers. Obviously you got the canoes, the Mark Twain, and obviously the train track runs around the back there as well. So it's got multi-purpose, I do like that. Train track at the back. Splash Mountain looks amazing from up here. Really, really good. All of Critter Country, all the way around. That's really, really nice. Having that railway track round here really adds to it as well. Everybody waving over in the queue.
See you in 3 hours.
Oh, I do love a good ride on the Mark Twain Riverboat. Really good to get back on that. But of course, it is 2 o'clock, which means it's parade time. We do love the parades, don't we?
Love the parade. And we get to sit on the floor and watch, which is a bit different.
Hopefully, we get some tangles. We want tangles. We want Rapunzel. We love Rapunzel. Especially Alex. He's got a bit of a crush on Rapunzel. So we'll. Especially the one over in Shanghai if you're watching this video. So here we go. Happiness is here. Very different audio for this. It's actually a lot quieter than normal because there's no actual speaker stands, especially around this area. So the audio is coming from like the buildings and the floats, which means I don't think it sounds as good, to be honest. Here we go. Here's some highlights of the parade.
there instead. Toy Story float, chassis up there at the front with Rex, Slinky down there.
Look at that. Next up then we're going on Pooh's Honey Hunt. Now Winnie the Pooh here is a little bit different than that at the other Disney parks, because here it's a trackless dart ride.
Wait.
What is it, Alex?
Trackless dart ride called Pooh's Honey Hunt.
A trackless dart ride, and I love trackless dart rides. Of course, Mystic Manor, what we did over in Hong Kong, Ratatouille at Walt Disney Studios in Paris, and I can't wait. It's a massive e-ticket ride here. I mean, look at it.
It looks beautiful.
It does. I mean, look at all the queue line and everything. I'm just saying, I think the people of Japan really like
Winnie the Pooh. It's just been in the gift shop as well, and literally it's so big and full of Pooh merchandise.
So hopefully the ride won't be Pooh, but we'll enjoy it.
I was going to say, we're going on a hunt. I hope it's a stunning hunt. I like a good stunning hunt, don't you?
I can't wait for this. I think it's going to be fantastic. With it being trackless as well, some of the scenes in here look really, really good.
One of the attractions from this park that I know quite a bit about, and I have watched a POV of before, so let's get on board.
Oh wow, look at all this interior queue line. This is really nice. So many details to see in here.
Feel into the book now.
Into the book.
The book.
Ah, good book.
Look at this. Very, very different. I'm looking forward to getting on board. Seeing what this is like. Looks brilliant, like I say, from what I've seen.
Like a window.
Yeah, look, a little bit breezy here today as well.
It's a book in a window.
It's a what? It's a book in a window.
It's a book. It's a book in a window.
Chapter one. There we are, we get on just up there by the looks of it.
Here we go. Wow. Nice.
I won't ever see another Winnie the Pooh the same. Look at this.
Oh my god. The smell as well in here.
Yeah, really good smells.
Wow.
It's amazing what you can do with a trackless dart ride when you really put your mind to it. If you love Winnie the Pooh, you need to get yourself out here to Tokyo. Oh. Wow, look at this, trackless.
Oh my god.
So we're interacting with all the other vehicles now in the room.
It's like a nightclub for Winnie the Pooh. Whoa.
Also notice how you've got the one with the carrots on there as well. Really good.
Incredible.
Here we are, we're going to our little section. This is brilliant. Why can't we have a poo like this everywhere?
Have a poo like this all over the world.
Fantastic, that was. Brilliant. Full review when we come off.
Oh wow, that was absolutely fantastic. And like I say, I've watched a POV of that before. And again, it's one of those where POVs just don't do it justice. Even the video I took for Ian there, just, yes, you see it forwards or however I'm facing the camera. But bear in mind with a dark ride like that, especially with it being trackless, it's 360, there's stuff all the way around. You look up, you look down, side to side. A POV really doesn't do that ride justice. I thought it was brilliant. How was Pooh?
I enjoyed Pooh, yeah. It was really, really good. Well themed, and the scenes sort of flow nice into one another as well. There's no sort of instant change of the transitions, the audio, the sights, the sounds, the smells. So, like, using the five senses, really.
All the rooms were really well partitioned off, weren't they, as well, with doors and...
And everybody got a different experience, so if we went on again, we'd probably get something completely different.
Yeah.
We were watching other people get other things, and we didn't get ourselves, so...
There was a great room with Tigger, where the whole floor sort of bounced and gave us that really good illusion, wasn't it? That we were bouncing a lot more than we were, and that was great.
Imagine taking a very young child and how immersive that.
They would love it. Oh my god.
We're grown ups and we love it. So imagine what kind of world a child's going to experience on that.
It was just brilliant. I mean, it makes all the other poos in the world look a bit poo, to be honest. You know? no pun intended.
Have a poo as good as that.
You can stop with these poo jokes now. I really enjoyed that. I thought it was a really good feel-good dark ride. Brilliant. If you love Winnie the Pooh, get yourself out here. It's Tokyo Disneyland.
Tokyo and
Pooh. Yeah, there you go. That was awesome. I won't ever see the others the same again now. Wow, that was awesome. Really, really good.
Are the poos in the toilet?
Shut up. So windy here today. Still can't get over how busy this place is. Everybody said, Sean, the queues are going to be manic, it's going to be rammed, and it really is. But it's amazing to see. Just having a little walk then down from Toontown into Tomorrowland, and I must say, at the moment, it's a bit underwhelming, this area.
Tomorrowland at the minute.
It is, I mean, there's not a lot to see. Obviously, something's happening over here. Magic is happening behind that board, whatever that might be. And Starjet's just here. Is going to be closing this October for good. So this whole area is going to be redeveloped into something. God, it's so windy today. Yeah, it's just a little bit bland, like all the buildings. I mean, I know they're trying to go more futuristic and stuff, but again, it just doesn't work in my eyes. They need to go with what they've done at Shanghai, which is brilliant.
Welcome to my Star Tours, the adventure continues. Queue line overview, follow me this way. This is our queue line so far. You can tell we've run out of queue line, we've had to use extended rope. But unfortunately, the extended rope is finished, so we're going to have to just use normal pathways.
Oh my god, big queue. Oh my god.
My good friend Baba there.
How long's the queue?
Baba Fett, that is. I reckon, over 10,000 minutes.
10,000 minutes.
Which in English is actually 40 minutes according to the standard.
That's not too bad, 40 minutes.
Quite reasonable.
I think that's worth the game for 40 minutes.
Yeah.
That's not too bad.
Let's see how long it lasts.
So we're in the queue for Star Tours. They're advertising as a 45-minute wait now. To me, this looks absolutely massive. There must not be loads of indoor queue, but we'll soon find out.
We hope anyway.
It's all the way up there, but we timed it, haven't we? It was, what, 3:45 when we joined the queue.
We're expecting to be on by around about 4:30.
So we'll keep you updated. Start all of the adventures continue. Presented by JCB. Not the JCB, though. That would be very strange, wouldn't it? Just done the massive indoor cattle pen queue line where you saw just, and it's been 50 minutes now since we joined the queue. We've come through into another room, but I think we're going to be getting our glasses just through there, hopefully. Start speed of 1,000.
Glasses yet?
I know, yeah, I hope so.
There's
all of the departures.
We are now ready to begin pre-boarding.
Pre-boarding is beginning. Fantastic. Right, we'll see you on the ride. Let's go.
All passengers traveling with young people.
The Avengers continue. I personally enjoy the new version. I didn't really like it before.
No, it's much better than the original, and it was nice to have a new video in there. I've got to say, it was really nice. It's something refreshing. We saw Chewbacca on this one quite a few times, actually, didn't we?
We did, yeah. It was good to see Chewie. It was. We were like, wait.
Yeah, we think the only ones who liked him, really.
Make sure you check out our other vlog where we do a meet and greet with him. And it was fantastic, wasn't it? When we were at Hong Kong.
So amazing.
Yeah, so good. Yeah, I really do like it. I mean, I'm not a massive fan of Star Wars, so to speak, but I really like Star Tours. I think it's fantastic. And yeah, it was good to see Chewie in there. We do like Chewie. Some of the best meet and greets we've ever had on this trip. Well, definitely the best meet and greets we've ever had on this trip. But overall, it was very, very good, as Alex said. It was good to see a different video. I'd not seen that one before. You reckon there's so many different videos out there. I'm not sure on the exact number, but I know it's a lot. And I seem to see the same ones all the time. That one was different, so it was good to see it.
I've got to say, though, Merlin Entertainment needs to be advertising their business in Disney parks. Because look, Galactica, Pan Galactica Pizza Port. But to be fair, the theming, very, very cool.
Now that's better than VR.
Look at that.
Oh.
How cool.
Oh, that's really nice. Oh, I wasn't expecting that. God, look at how many moving parts there is there. That's brilliant. It's a bit like Cosmic Rays Starlight Cafe over at Magic Kingdom. Oh, wow. That's really cool. Yeah, enjoyed Star Tours. We've got Buzz Lightyear coming up next. Oh yeah, Galactica Pizza. Oh my god, it's Buzz Lightyear. Off we go, on Buzz. Quick, we need to get in, come on! Come off Buzz Lightyear, and we're just down the other end now of Tomorrowland, what leads back to World Bazaar. This is a very interesting area. I mean, it's quite strange having an entry point here, isn't it? Especially like a little corridor, so to speak, what leads you through. Let's have a little look. Lots of detail on the top just there. This takes us back to this park's version of Main Street USA. Still all American-inspired shops, like the Emporium and all that kind of stuff. But under the name of World Bazaar. And I've grown to quite like it, actually. I think it's very different, and I like all the differences we've seen on this trip.
The rain or shine, stand under, raw bazaar, you'll stay dry.
Lots of shops to look around, so that's what we're going to do now, have a little look at some of the merchandise available.
I feel like Town Centre Fashions will suit you, sure.
Well, let's start off in Town Centre Fashions, then. Let's go. Whee! send us a postcard next time.
You had a little bit of a trip.
Let's have a look at the merch. Love the merch. Are you happy as a rainbow? Some great character merchandise here. Oh wow. Oh wow, look at these shirts. Oh my god, it's even got the monorail. It's even got the monorail.
It's really exciting, right? It's a nice shirt, but it's also nice on the back. Big thunder.
That is amazing. You got Space Mountain down there too.
And there's a daylight one.
Oh wow.
This is it.
I don't have no money left.
Oh my god.
Sorry, mum.
This is the best merch. Look at this. Oh, they're quite silky as well.
Silky smooth.
This is a really nice feature on World Bazaar. I like all this. Look at all these. Really cool. Tokyo Disneyland. Little souvenirs. Change for it there as well. Uncle Sam over here as well. Answer you a question.
You see that man in there? Okay. Alright. Tell me what he's doing when I press this button. Get around the corner and have a look, ready?
Welcome to Disney. Look at all these photos. Oh, wow. Oh, some of these are right classics in here, aren't they? There you go, I'll go with Lee. Have a go with Lee. Hey. Leewood, everybody. Oh, this is really quite authentic. I like it. All these pictures on the wall. It's all like old amusement parks and stuff.
Around the world.
Yeah, this is really nice. This isn't even the Emporium we've been in yet. This is like walking up just one side.
These parts I can recognise. I'm struggling, I've got to be honest.
Crazy, this is. Some really good books down here as well, all about the parks. Imagineering the magic. Tokyo Disney Sea Chronicle, 15th anniversary. Cinderella Castle 100, loads of really nice books. We've got loads of soundtracks over here as well. Mermaid Lagoon music album. Once Upon a Time, the nighttime shows. Tokyo Disneyland Electrical Parade. What are you doing? Are you listening to all the CDs? Oh, that's quite cool. This looks amazing. Big Band beat there as well. There you go, have a rave to the Tokyo Disneyland Electrical Parade Dream Lights. Got all the Easter soundtracks up there as well. Oh my god, so much merch. This one is just for you, Harry. Mr. Harry Turnstiles himself. I know you like your magic. Look at this big magic shop. Wow. Even do a bit of live magic, I'm sure. Okay. Looks like the one at Disneyland if you want a trick demonstrating the will be. That's all really cool. Look at all that.
It's a magic book.
Okay, a magic book.
It's a black book.
It's a very black book.
Nothing
in the book. Okay.
Could you touch it? Sat mite. So. Sabaru to nam to.
Oh.
The Mickey Mouse, the Disneyland. But no colors. I have a crayon. It's a magic crayon. Like this. Peeling. This color, like this, 1, 2, 3, and all color, and
very, very good.
Just disappear.
I love it all, guys.
Magic book.
The magic book. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So I think we've just got a little bit distracted by our visit to Tokyo Disneyland, that we actually, earlier on, when we visited Adventureland, forgot to come and ride one of our favourites, Pirates of the Caribbean. I mean, we just completely forgot about this attraction, didn't we? It's like Pirates of the Caribbean, how can we forget that?
Probably one of our favourites ever.
Probably one of our favourites ever. And to be honest, it's nestled away, quite close to the World Bazaar. I just walked around the corner and saw a sign saying Pirates of the Caribbean, and was like, Pirates, we've got to go on.
Well, the thing is, Disney Sea is what draws many of the visitors here.
Yeah, it's what drew me here, to be honest.
So it's going to be interesting to see actually a very California style pirates in a very different park.
It is, because this section we're in now in particular, pretty much identical to California. Obviously you've got all that expanded queue line there.
But this is normally just there, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, yeah, like a little courtyard area.
Song parrot, feel free to join in anytime.
So we've just come off Pirates of the Caribbean, and what can I say about that? It was very, very, very similar to that of Disneyland in California's version of the ride. Of course, the original Pirates of the Caribbean, very, very similar to that. It was great, wasn't it? Did you enjoy Pirates?
It was lovely, yeah. It's, very similar. A few differences to California's, but all around, just a lovely ride, isn't it? It's really
classic. It's great to get back on a classic version of Pirates of the Caribbean. And they've also got their own sort of version of New Orleans Square. But here it's actually classed as part of Adventureland. It's not actually called New Orleans Square, even though it does look very, very similar, and practically identical in terms of all the architecture and buildings around here. But it does fit into Adventureland very well, actually. It's very, very nice. And you've got the Blue Bay restaurant. You saw a little shot at the start of the clip, actually, when we were on the ride, where you just got to see the restaurant when you're on there. But yeah, I really enjoyed that. Like Alex said, very, very similar. A few little differences in there, like the offload is in a different place. You actually get off and onload at the same place in California, whereas here it's got its own offload and then a travelator up to the top. But yeah, it was great to see Jack Sparrow in there, of course, at the end. That was a little bit different to that of California, and the fact that it was in a bit of a different position, a different place. But overall, really, really good to get on Pirates of the Caribbean.
We do love a good classic dark ride here at Disney, and it's starting to get dark. Disney parks are always the best at night. What a great day we're having.
Really do like World Bazaar, especially at night. It's really, really nice, and the roof actually adds a really nice touch. We've seen some very different variations on Main Street USA. Of course, Mickey Avenue at Shanghai Disney a few days ago. We've seen the World Bazaar here. It's been fantastic to see these different versions, and I've really, really liked both of them. And Alex made a really good point just
saying that it reminds him of Studio One.
Because, yeah,
in what these studios.
A very indoor-y feel, doorsy feel. Good purpose for you, and obviously the weather isn't always this nice here. I approve. It's really, really well detailed. We didn't even know about these little side lanes.
Yeah, like it's like a big sort of plus symbol, isn't it? With the lanes. It's very, very nice down there.
Let's have a look in this window though and see.
Oh, look at this. We've just been having a look at merchandise. There's quite a lot, lots of character related stuff.
Toy Story Mania, Toyville, Trolley Park, Tokyo Disney Resort, what's up that? Gorgeous little items, train sets.
Hopefully the merch is going to be even better in Tokyo Disney Sea, and you will find out tomorrow. But for now, we're going on another dark ride, Monsters, Inc. Now, we're not too sure what this is. We know it's some sort of track dark ride, but is it going to be the same as what's available over at California Adventurer? We will soon find out.
I do really like the inside section of this, though. It's just like from the movie.
Yeah, it looks very nice.
The big reception area of Monsters Incorporated. Very well detailed, very well themed. Hopefully, Sean will get some footage of that for you.
I will do. Let's go and have a look. Brought to you by Panasonic, this one. It's worth pointing out a lot of the rides here. Brought to you by different companies, or presented by, as Disney like to go. It's very impressive in here. To the left floors.
It's a very complicated queue system to plan out this. I mean, it's a circle. Normally squares are a little bit easier to navigate. Rather a circle, very, very different.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Yeah, it is. Lots to see.
Where's Roz when you need it?
I'm watching you. Well, Alex. I'm watching you on Theme Park Worldwide on YouTube.
I've never heard you that voice. I hope you never do it again.
Well, I won't do it until we're off the attraction and I share my review. But right now, my voice is hurting, so I'm going to stop and we'll get on the ride. Wazowski.
Thank you.
See you later, viewers. Let's get on the ride. So on this one, we even get a flashlight. Look at this. There he is. What do we do with the flashlight? I haven't done it.
Yeah, Nina, end it. Okay.
And the monster. So there's no point scoring or anything on this. Just for fun. Should we go through? Noise when you hit one. It's quite well themed in here. Really good. Yeah, a little bell goes off.
So, Alex, what did you think to the ride?
I'll tell you when you stop doing the voice.
Okay.
What do you think of the ride?
That was great, yeah, I really enjoyed it. Yeah, very well themed, and I managed to get all but two of them. I saw every little corner, every edge of the room, but I got all but two, and that was purely because of the angle I was at the time of the ride motion. Very happy.
Theming in there was very good.
Yeah,
I like Monsters, Inc. as well. I think it was a very good film. I think that's a very good ride to fit the film. I preferred that to the version at California. I do like the room with all the doors in California, though, where they're all around. But that was really good. And the tours, it was very weird. It was like I was kind of expecting to get a score at the end, and I didn't. I think it's just for fun, isn't it, the targets, really? But, there they are, two brothers. Yeah, it was good fun. You know, I did enjoy it. It was a good ride, that was. A good ride.
Doesn't like my beard.
Oh, what do you think, viewers? Comment below. Beard, remove or stay?
Or grow.
By the time this goes up, though, it could have gone.
It might have gone, yeah, I'm tempted.
Oh, I think you should keep it. I like it, I think it makes it look more
manly.
Hardly.
Right, we're going to make our way outside because it is time for the nighttime parade.
I'm holding shoes.
What are you doing? He's been holding them all day. I've told him, get a bag.
Yeah, I've got a bit sore feet, so I need some spare shoes just in case.
Oh, sympathy.
I've got the red Converse. I've actually got real Converse.
Look at that. You've got real shoes. These aren't Converse, mate. These are Dunlop.
Oh, cheap.
Dunlop, mate. Dunlop.
Happy birthday, Sean.
Thanks. Parade time.
Hey, here we go. We love a good night parade.
Parade time.
It's time for Tokyo Disneyland.
Our last ever night parade at a Disney park.
Oh my God, this is so sad.
Hello there. Have you been a good little boy?
Hello, everyone. Oh, my, what a magical evening! This is such a wonderful place, don't you agree?
So we've just watched Tokyo Disneyland Electrical Parade Dream Lights, which was absolutely awesome. I really enjoyed that. And that is my favorite nighttime parade. I wasn't expecting to be saying that. I mean, I knew I was gonna enjoy it a lot, but I thought maybe after seeing Paint the Night, I won't enjoy it quite as much, but I did. I absolutely loved that. I stood there, my mouth was like this. I was in awe looking at that. It was absolutely beautiful. What I loved so much about it was very similar to the Main Street Electrical Parade in the fact it had all that heritage to it. A lot of the classic Disney was in that. And it had some really modern stuff in there as well, such as the Peter Pan float. That was fantastic. So you had the big ship and it had all the lights on there all changing. And of course, lots of LED involved in it as well. I thought that was stunning. It also has to be the longest night parade, if not one of the longest Disney parades out there. It was stunning, it really was. The runtime for that must be over 20 minutes from start to finish. Really, really good. a fantastic combination of floats. I love the costumes. I really liked how there was a Tangled float in there as well. That was amazing. My favourite float in that has to be the three right at the end, because they've got It's a Small World soundtrack playing, which is great. And then what I love about it is they're all in sync with each other lighting wise. So 1 minute they'll all be doing different colours, then they all go white. It was very, very clever and very, very nice how it was done. I just loved how it had that classic Disney feel mixed in with modern Disney too. I love Paint the Night Parade so much. I love all these nighttime parades. I absolutely love them at Disney parks. I think they are a must, and the parks that don't have night parades at the moment, I really hope they do get some. However, that for me was beautiful, and it really touched a nerve for me that day. I've not felt like that about a parade for a very long time. I don't know what Alex thought, but I personally loved that to bits.
For me, yeah, 100% agree. Very different, very Main Street Electrical feel, but actually very, very different. Very modern, very contemporary, very up to date, and I kind of like that. I'm not full of video screens, technology, just lights, and you know what, that is what
lots of lights as well.
A lot of lights.
Yeah. And I think that's what I do miss slightly with Paint the Night. Like, there's not loads of lights in it, is there? It is more video screens. I mean, I love the scale, and it's worth pointing out that the float size here, they are a lot smaller floats in that than Paint the Night, but there's a lot more of them.
Grand scale play.
Yeah, you won't be looking up like that. You want to be quite close to the front, don't you, as well, for that one?
Yeah, oh yeah.
But yeah, it was
a lot more performers as well than Paint the Night.
Yeah, it was a lot more performers, a lot more going on, a lot more classic Disney, and it was brilliant. I love all the night parades though, but that one for me, just it touched the nerve inside, and I just thought it was brilliant.
Really, really nice
that was. So we're now gathered in Central Plaza, the hub. Let's have a look at the lights. I mean, looking back there on the World Bazaar, that looks gorgeous at night with all the lights. Your typical Main Street USA, nice lights all the way around there. They continue all the way around the hub, all on these different areas, which is nice. And we're stood right in the middle. Quite interesting here, you've got four turrets in front. Now at Walt Disney World, the Magic Kingdom, you've got two turrets, which are just down the two down at the front there, which are very different actually. They actually have the techie booths in for the show. Here you've got the four, obviously all to do with the show. I'm not too sure if the techie booths are in there or anything like that, but obviously I think the speakers are inside, there's lighting, the projectors for the castle, all sorts of stuff going on. You can actually see, if I zoom in on that turret just there, how the wall opens up to hide the tech inside, so that's very, very clever. But yeah, we're just gonna hang on here for a little bit, about 20 minutes to go until the nighttime show on Cinderella's Castle. Very nicely lit up as well, really nice purple lighting.
So the time has come for the nighttime fireworks here at Tokyo Disneyland. It's our first fireworks show to watch on this castle, and it's called Happiness on High.
Are you ready for Happiness on High?
The name is a bit interesting, isn't it?
It is quite interesting. But here we go, a crowd has gathered.
We'll give it a go.
So here we go, here's some highlights over the next few minutes of the nighttime fireworks show here at Tokyo Disneyland. It's Happiness on High. Seen some footage there from Happiness on High, which was around a 5 minute firework display, which there were some great fireworks and that, really good fireworks. However, there was one problem with that show, and that was that the fireworks, as you saw from the footage, were actually nowhere near Cinderella's Castle. They were way off to the left hand side, which I'm quite surprised about actually, because I have watched a video of that show before and it was short and all that, and it wasn't focused on the castle. But I'm sure in the video that I watched, it must have been filmed from a different angle, the fireworks were at least a little bit closer to the castle.
I'm going to say the title of the show, which we're not going to say again purely because of what I'm about to say,
which is Happiness on High.
Right, I was going to say that clearly the techie is implying something when whoever designed that show, because really, what I can't even.
But don't worry, the next show is on the castle.
I'm just like, I'm watching the castle central, and then next thing, there's fireworks over there.
It's
like,
called Once Upon a Time, the next show. And this is a proper going through the stories, projections, special effects. So this should be a lot better. I think the reason, to be honest, they're over there to the left is mainly because of we are in the middle of a city, aren't we? And obviously, a bit like Disneyland in California, they're off to an angle as well. Not quite as much as that, but they are off to an angle. And I think obviously there must be like a main road or something, literally not far.
I've got to mention though that, like, I'm trying not to laugh.
But it's on high, everybody.
Sorry, but like, I don't get it at all. What did we?
I have to say that was the worst nighttime fireworks I've ever seen at any Disney park.
I was saying, for sure, like, I've seen my granddad in the garden light fireworks and run away from it more interesting than that. But
however, I'm looking forward to the castle show.
Yeah, it'll be
good. I'm going to show you a few minutes of highlights now. But yeah, there you go.
I think it's a Disney Dreams topper personally.
Yeah, worth coming out just for that. The fantastic Once Upon a Time, which, to be honest, was very, very good, wasn't it? I really enjoyed that. 20-minute long show. There was no sort of large fireworks in it. There was a few pyrotechnics on the castle, but it didn't need it, did it? Because that show was a combination of Disney animated classics, wasn't it?
And it had a fragment of Frozen, a nice section of Tangled, and the rest were... We're talking films from 20, 30, 40 years ago. It was nice.
I tell you what, they must love Alice in Wonderland over there.
Yeah, plenty of Alice.
Loads of Alice.
And the Beast as well was sort of
the main
narrative of the show. Oh, wow. And I had a tear.
Yeah, you had a little cry.
Every time.
I thought it was really nice. Of course, Winnie the Pooh was in it, Peter Pan. Loads of the classics. I really enjoyed it. It was a fantastic show. And as you saw, the fireballs as well, they were great. But there's a little part of me that still misses having some big fireworks going off with the show. As much as I really enjoyed that, and it didn't need fireworks, it was still very enjoyable, I think that experience will be enhanced even more
if it had fireworks.
I thought I was going for an underwhelmed fireworks display to an overwhelmed castle projection.
Yeah, it was a really good, it was better than, I forgot the name of it now, a few years ago, the Magic Kingdom, before they had the projection show and fireworks together, they had a separate show with projection mapping, and basically they had that, and that wasn't very good, and that there was really good. I really liked how the turrets at the side also projection mapped. I thought it was lovely. In terms of nighttime shows, I think it's probably the weakest of the Disney parks for nighttime shows, because I know there's a lot of people out there, including myself, that does like it to be on the castle, all there, whether it's fountains, projections, fire, whatever. I like it all to be there, but it was still very, very nice. That was, I still enjoy it.
And if you haven't guessed where we are right now, you're about to find out what we're about to do in the dark.
We was about to go on the Big Thunder Mountain, but unfortunately, it's conveniently down after the fireworks, the last hour of park.
So the fireworks were over, it just went down.
That's it, we're getting on the Mark Twain yet again. I've never actually done the riverboat at night at any Disney park. It's always a daytime thing for me. Yeah, definitely up to the top. Yeah, I've just never actually done it before.
I love the bowing here. I love how we bow to everyone and thank you and hello.
It is so polite. To be honest, it puts our country to shame. It really puts the UK to shame. And customer service here is amazing. I've never been spoken to so nicely and treated so nicely by anyone. I think it's really lovely country.
And I can't wait for this, our last couple of rides. Oh, you alright?
Yeah, I just slapped my head off. Oh. I went with my head.
Our last couple of rides
to end our day here at Tokyo Disneyland.
Mark Twain. Look at this.
So, whilst on quite possibly one of the most beautiful rides at any Disney park, I have to kind of say that, you know, I am a laugh and a joke person. I don't take life too seriously. And I like to be the butt of jokes, and I do many occasions express very silly and strange opinions, yet honestly right now I've never felt more at home in myself, and Disney for me is such a huge thing, and seeing this, being here in Tokyo, in Japan, something I never thought I'd go any further than Spain in my life, going a week abroad, all inclusive with my family. I thought that would be it. I thought that'd be as far travelled as I'd get, and to say I'm here
now.
It's
getting a bit deep, isn't it?
It is with the music. I feel humbled to be here and say I'm seeing it and showing it to you guys on camera. It really does come across as how incredible this place really is, and we haven't even as such done the part we're most anticipating yet. And I've had so many memories with Theme Park Worldwide, and honestly, without...
We have the best friendship group, don't we? And it's a shame that more people couldn't be here to sort of spend it with us out of our friendship group. Yeah. But it's a big trip to do, it really is. And it might not be for everyone, but we've come, we've done it. And like Alex just said, you know, we've got some amazing memories.
Me and Alex at all the Disney parks that we've done. Bear in mind, it's quite strange, actually, because me and Alex, the only Disney park we've not done together... It's
Walt Disney World.
Yeah, we've both done it, but we haven't been done it together. And hopefully, eventually, we will. So we can just say we've done it. Mark Twain.
Mark Twain.
I don't even consider it necessarily a friendship. Don't shout over a bell. Give it a minute for the bell to finish. Let's get those rings really in and the view. It's gorgeous. And there we go. I won't forget to finish. Honestly, I don't even consider Theme Park Worldwide my friendship group. They're my family.
And
it's the best feeling. And the people who watch this and tweet us an Instagram message or something, you're part of that family, and it's
A ride like this makes you quite emotional.
I'm not sure if you can feel the emotion back home, but for us, we really are theme park worldwide. We're not roller coaster worldwide. I stress that a lot. Being on a ride like this, it's a boat ride with some beautiful audio and so relaxing. There is roller coasters we could be riding, not Big Thunder Mountain because it's broken down, but there is coasters we could be riding, but we're not. We're here and just enjoying this night, and let's just say I think it's time we wrap up this vlog for today. We'll get off the boat, wrap it up, and sum up everything from today.
We really will.
Without that man there, I wouldn't be half the man I am.
Oh,
thank you. Thank
you. And we've done it together. It's so emotional, isn't it?
I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna stop talking.
Thanks for all the memories. And tomorrow we step into our final Disney park. We've done all the Disney parks and water parks in the world tomorrow.
And that dream becomes a reality, but there's many more things to come.
I'm not going
to
sleep tonight. Let's get off the boat and we'll summarise today. Mark 1, Mark 3. What a guy. Really nice relaxing ride there on the Mark Twain. Getting a little bit emotional, not gonna lie, because we've done it. We've been to the 6 Magic Kingdom style parks throughout the world. I mean, how does it feel to say that we've been to every Disneyland in the world?
The word that's used to describe all of these kingdoms, magical.
It really is. And I've done numerous vlogs from all these Disney parks over the years, and of course, started doing vlogs in 2012, and it was actually a Disneyland Paris vlog on the channel that was there right back at the very start. And I remember I was there on holiday with my mum, and obviously I've been visiting Disneyland Paris for years, but that was the first time I'd ever vlogged it and put it on YouTube. And I might have had a lot of, hey, Theme Park Worldwide on YouTube, check it out. I love it. YouTube, Theme Park Worldwide, check it out, see you later. Still doing it 5 years on. Anyway, going back to Disneyland Paris, over the years, I've had so many different thoughts on Disney parks, and I've shared so many different opinions, and I've compared a lot of things, what I kind of wish I hadn't compared. Now I've got to the stage, I never thought that I'd be here, standing in Tokyo, saying that I've completed all of them. And I think it's crazy to think that we have. I just wish that over the years, I didn't compare things as much, because each one has got its own special place in my heart for very different reasons. I love them all, I think they're all fantastic. And yes, I've got certain ones that I enjoy more. However, I think in terms of attractions, it's nice that we now have seen all 6. It's nice that each one has got different things. And I really appreciate that now and look back on it all and think, you know what? There isn't one that is bad. I have enjoyed each and every one of them for their own reasons, and they've all got attractions that I really, really enjoy at each and every one. They've all got the great rides, they've all got the bad rides, they've all got the amazing rides, and they've all got different things. But at the end of the day, it's still Disneyland, and we've done all 6. And tomorrow we'll step into our 12th Disney park, and we've done every Disney park.
Not just Disneyland, it's crazy.
And with these parks, like the what style that we're visiting today, and you've seen on this vlog so far, Sean and I have been saying all day about how a lot of people say it's a Magic Kingdom park all over the world, but with differences. No, I would disagree with that statement completely. They are completely separate parks with similarities to one another.
Yeah, I'd agree.
They have very similar elements. Most of them, very similar in layout. I will stand by that. However, they each have their own unique charm. And to think July 17th, 1955, to where we are now, this is one journey. One journey that, yes, we've shared together and we have our own pathways. There are millions and millions of people who are visiting Disney parks all over the world this week alone, this month, this year. And the magic we feel, overwhelming.
We love these parks, don't we? And in terms of, let's just talk about Tokyo Disneyland, I really enjoyed this park. This morning when I first walked in, I'm not gonna lie, I was feeling a little bit like, oh, I'm not too sure. There's all the conservatory and the areas are quite big. As soon as we started walking around, I noticed the little details. And again, it was Adventureland and Westernland, as it's called here. It still seems strange saying that.
And seeing all those details, it made me think, actually, you know what? This is a very, very nice park. And it's made me, I've just been thinking all day about this and thinking, I enjoy all of them. I don't walk out of any of them and think, oh, that was bad compared to so-and-so. I love them all. And this is a really, really nice park that I can't wait to come back into in just a couple of days' time and see the things that we haven't done today.
We've done it. The moment.
This is it.
This is the moment.
It's
this is
so
it.
This is the, emotional.
It really is. It's almost like a heartbreak, but you know what? It doesn't feel like a bad one. It feels like my heart's breaking because I've done it. We've done it together. We've done it.
And yeah. Tomorrow's the big one because we're going to what could potentially be our favourite ever theme park, the most beautiful theme park in the world, one of the most expensive theme park projects ever to be built. It's Tokyo Disney Sea. It's the second gate park here that opened in 2001. And I am so excited to get in there and see it. I really am. So on that note, let's wrap this one up and we'll see you tomorrow at Tokyo Disney Sea. Oh my
The rest
God.
Of the world, come get us.
This is it. That means it's time to cue those credits. See you later, guys, from Tokyo Disneyland.